Hi, I'm Darren Terpstra, exhibit designer with the University of Minnesota Libraries Archives and Special Collections, and I'd like to welcome you to our latest exhibit, The Best of Pen and Press. This exhibit encompasses two galleries in the Elmer L. Anderson Library. To tell us more about this exhibit is one of the co-curators, Marguerite Ragnow, and we're going to join her here in the James Ford Bell Gallery.
One of the things we were hoping to accomplish with this exhibition is to bring materials out for the general public to see that they can actually relate to. In one of the cases in this gallery, we have cuneiform that's more than 3,000 years old. We have a book that contains an etching by Rembrandt. We have on exhibit in this gallery the actual account of William Bligh's mutiny on the Bounty, not only the mutiny, but his incredible journey in an open boat with 18 men across 3,000 miles of the Pacific Ocean. We have a handwritten charter from King James I of England written to the Emperor of Japan in 1611.
We really are kind of hinging on two things, the pen and the press. It's sometimes easy to wrap our head around the press. We've made this great scene of a press operator with an actual functioning press that we use today for educational purposes in classroom. We have a desk set up with a quill and notes and an ink reservoir. So people get the sense of how these things were created. Everything was created by hand. And you can see that from very old scrolls and objects that we have to something very contemporary like a broadside or a poster. Here to tell us more about some of the objects in the focus in the atrium gallery is co-curator Tim Johnson.
So one of the items we have on display is something that really nobody's probably ever seen before. It's called a Remembrancer's Scroll. It's English from, I believe, about the 17th century. And it was put together by an official in the court, either of the queen or the king, a list of items that needed to be attended to, and the Remembrancer was there to remind the monarch, to remind members of the exchequer, other important people in court, about what needed to be attended to. This is an exhibit that has broad appeal, from school groups to retired adults. Everybody will find something of interest here. From viewing the oldest items we have in the collection, which include papyri fragments that are thousands of years old, to items that were produced just within the last few years. When people see it, they will go, wow.